So good morning, my dear students. We were not able to do second part of the poem. That is a very beautiful part. I think we all should discuss it. Okay. So, and you all should be very much eager to tell me the answer. I want that my all students should raise their hands. They should participate in class. Okay. So the question is that when you were a young child, did your mother tuck you in as the poets did? Did your mother tuck you in as the poets did? Tell me, can you recall those days when you were too young? Still you are young, but you just recall all those days when you were too much young, like a very small child. So your mother used to tuck you in, yes or no? So you have to write down an answer, yes or no. So who is going to tell me this answer in a beautiful way? In a beautiful way, who is going to tell me this answer? Okay, Dhiren.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I want to ask in this question, we have to just give our context, or we also have to give the context in poem also?
Oh, no, you have to give your point, your experience.
Okay, ma'am. So, ma'am, may I answer now?
Yes, Achyut.
Ma'am, when I was a young child, I used to then there was used to rain. At the time, I just tucked up my mother, and she helped me a lot. During these days, when I was young, I just loved my mother's company, and I slept with her. I just when she tucked up, I feel a different type of security, and that couldn't be given out in form of words.
Okay, good. The same answer, Riti. Can you tell me, Riti Kapoor? Riti Kapoor, can you tell me this answer? No? Okay, now next question. Do you like rain? What do you do when it rains steadily or heavily as described in the poem? So I think everybody likes rain. Your answer will be in the form of a yes. But when it steadily rains or when it heavily rains, so what do you do? Every person does different activities. You can tell about your experience. Okay, some goes out and they enjoy the weather. Some sit in four walls. Some enjoy snacks and tea. Some enjoy, you can say, watching the rain from their window. So everybody is having different experience. So Arzu, you tell me about your experience. After Arzu, Divyanshi should be ready.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Yes, I like the rain lot. The dreaming of the raindrops on the window panes and the picture that permits the environment when the soft showers drench the parched earth. Fill my senses with lots of sweetness. I look forward to stepping into the puddles on the road and making paper boats and set them float in the rainwater. I think there is not one living being that does not celebrate the onset of the monsoon. But when the clouds unleash their fury and it rains heavily, I have no choice but to sit indoors. I feel sad for the homeless people and the abandoned animals that have no shelter over their heads.
Which student was it? I forgot. What's your name? Arzu. Okay. Arzu, you have spoken so well. Your answer was perfect. Now, after Arzu, I expect this answer from Sumati. Yes, Sumati. Yes, Sumati. Smriti, shall I mark you absent today? You are not responding in my class. Shall I mark you absent today? Now tell me. Smriti, you are not responding in class. Yes, this fake ID has been removed by me. Yes, I have removed that fake ID. Now tell me, Sumati. See, she is not responding. Okay, Nitish, what have you written? What is your answer, Nitish? Yes, Nitish. Those who are not responding in my class, I'm going to mark them absent today. Okay, Nitish, what is your answer?
Hello.
Okay, Jayati, you tell me, do you like rain? What do you do when it rains steadily or heavily as described in the poem?
Yes, I like to enjoy in the rain, as we all love to enjoy the weather, but I also like to go out in the rain and play out with my friends and you with my brother in the pond. We play with paper boats. There is a different kind of freshness after it rains, and the sweet patter of the rain drops also give us a that to refreshing movement. But in heavy rain, there is no choice. We all have to sit inside. The poor people who live outside their homes have to face a lot of difficulties. Their cottages thrashed with leaking roofs. Rich people sit comfortably. Those who are burdened with a busy schedule, they feel uncomfortable when they have to run around in the rain. But we should all enjoy the rain. Also, rain is not a bliss for everybody.
Very good, very good. You have described this answer so beautifully. All the ideas are properly arranged, and the conclusion you have written so well. Okay, now same answer I expect from Renuka also. After Renuka, Pranay should be ready. After Renuka, Pranay should be ready with the answer. Yes, Renuka. Renuka. Nowadays, Renuka is not answering in the class. Now, Pranay has left the class because I'm going to listen from him. Renuka, you unmute yourself. Wait. You unmute yourself now. Renuka, you unmute yourself and tell me the answer. I don't know what problem is going on. So everybody will have a different experience that they like rain or not. So Pranay, your answer is ready or not? Pranay is writing, ma'am, yes, same problem. I'm not able to unmute yourself. When you don't know the answer, you are not able to unmute yourself. I know it very well. So you frame this answer on your own. Okay, now let's move to, because you can tell about your experience that you like rain, yes or no? I think 99% will say yes. Okay. Some enjoy tasty food, some enjoy tasty snacks, some like to sit inside the walls, some like to sit near the window. They want to see the rain falling, they want to listen the soft sound. So you can tell about all the experience of yourself. Now, third question is, does everybody have a cozy bed to lie in when it rains? It means when it is raining, everybody has a cozy bed. It means they sleep in their bed so comfortably. You just look around you and suppose it is raining. Do you think all the people are staying in their house? They are sitting comfortably in their bed if it is raining? Look around you. All are not so lucky enough that they get cozy bed, because there are so many persons they have to move from their coziness, they have to move from their comfort level. Okay, even animals run here and there during rain in order to find out shelter. Okay, so the people also run here and there sometime on the road when they are passing by and it starts raining. So they also have to find out the shelter if they are on foot. Okay, shopkeepers, if their stalls are in open, then they have to do this arrangement. Okay, and there are so many people, they have to, those who are traveling, going here and there, they have to face problems. So who is going to tell me this simple answer? Daljeet, are you ready with your answer? This class performance is going so down. I have to do something on this Sunday. Okay, Daljeet, is your answer ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me.
No, everybody. Everybody not having a cozy bed to lie. Homeless people have to go here and there to seek shelter when it rains heavily. Animals also have to go here and there for seeking shelter. It is very difficult for the homeless people to live in the. It is very difficult for the homeless people to seek shelter when it rains. Ma'am, this much I.
Okay, good. Nice effort. So same answer, Jasleen. You tell me. Yes, Jasleen Khosla, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Everybody is not fortunate enough to have a cozy bed to lie when it rains. Everybody looks for shelter when it's rain, and the animals seek for shelter under, and sometimes they take shelter under the trees, and the shopkeepers who used to stalls are very delicate to enjoy the rain, and some people take tea and snacks from the shopkeepers, and this much I have written.
Okay, you add some more points in your answer, otherwise it was okay. Now I expect this answer from Laksh. Laksh, you tell me this answer.
Yes, good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, I know everybody doesn't have a cozy bed to lie in because there are many people in this world. We don't expect such things from everyone because people that are homeless, they don't have any home, so they don't have any cozy bed to lie. Animals, tree animals are also facing discomfort during the rain, and street food and etc. Like the shopkeepers are also facing difficulty during the rains.
Okay, good. Good. So your answer was good. Now, bachche, from this poem, you have to do some of the extra questions that I'm going to write down here. You just jot down these questions. What does a poet consider a bliss? What does a poet consider a bliss? According to poet, what is bliss? First of all, you should know the meaning of bliss. Bliss means utmost happiness. Utmost happiness. So according to poet, what is bliss for him? tell me. Let's write down hints for that. First of all, you should know the meaning of bliss. This means utmost happiness. According to poet, what is the moment of happiness? Yes, to enjoy. Coziness. To enjoy cozy. Bed. During rain. Yes. See, it's raining outside. People are struggling, but he is in his bed, in his cottage. Okay. Enjoying soft sound of rain. Yes. Which is pattering? Which patter? On the roof of the cottage. Roof of the cottage. So who is going to tell me this answer with the help of these points? Hurry up. Let me find out intelligent stuff for my class. Okay, Dhiren Haraparan has written to recover our recollection of memories. Yes. Yes, to recover recollection of memories. Yes. So who is going to tell me this answer? Hurry up. Raise your hand for this answer. So this is your question. Hints I have provided you. So who will tell me this answer? Tell me. Who will tell me? I can ask this answer from any of the child. Because this answer you can find out by going through only first stanza. So Ikjot, you tell me this answer. And you are supposed to do these questions in your fair notebook. You are supposed to do these questions in your fair notebook. Nitish was not able to unmute himself, but he has sent me very good answer. Okay. Nitish, your answer is absolutely fine. Very much correct. Good efforts. So Ikjot, Jaskirat Singh.
You tell me. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me this answer.
Ma'am, I want to prepare. Please give me some time.
Screen is not visible to you.
Ma'am, yes.
So write it, it is written in front of you. You can frame answer from there.
Yes, ma'am.
Start framing 2-3 lines.
Just.
Hurry up, bachche, why are you wasting my time? Only 6-7 students are participating in class. Those who are not participating, I'm going to mark them absent. See, hints are written in front of you. I have typed in front of you. You can pick up all the points and you can frame your answer, but still, if you are not putting any effort, it means you are not interested. And today in PTM, I'm going to talk to these parents. Okay, Mitash, you tell me this answer. Yes, Mitash. Now unmute yourself.
Ma'am.
Yes.
In the poem Rain on the Roof, the poet relates the various blissful emotions he has while he lies comfortably in his bed. For him, it is pure bliss to listen to the patter of the rain drops falling on the roof, but enjoying this bliss is not a privilege for everyone. There are many poverty-stricken people for whom rain brings a number of difficulties. Some of these people are without shelter, while some live in poor, thatched cottages with leaking roofs. When we look around, we find people reacting differently to the rain. Rich people sit comfortably in their luxurious houses and enjoy delicious snacks while watching rain. Those who are burdened with a busy schedule feel uncomfortable when they have to run around in their houses.
Okay, good. Perfectly written. Very nice. Your answer is absolutely correct. Now, bachche, write down next question. What thoughts appear? What thoughts appear in poet's mind when it rains? Now you have to describe all kinds of thoughts which comes in his mind. Okay? You have to tell about this thing that he has an echo in his heart. He has an echo in his heart. Okay? You have to describe this thing that he has an echo in his heart. Dreamy fancies, to tell about his imaginations, past experience, sweet, as well as sad and gloomy memories. So, bache, I have provided you so many hints. I have typed in front of you that when it is raining, what kind of thoughts appear in poet's mind. So you pick up all these points. With the help of these points, you can frame your answer. So who is going to frame this answer? And you are supposed to do this long answer in your fair notebook. Okay, Nitya, are you ready with your answer? After Nitya, Pranshi should be ready.
Ma'am, just a minute.
After Nitya, Pranshi should be ready with the answer.
While it was raining outside, the poet laid down on his bed and resting on his pillow, and he was having memories and flashbacks of his mother during his childhood, when his mother used to tuck him in his bed. And he also was having fantasies, dreamy fantasies and imaginations, or all his past memories flashed in front of his eyes, and he was sad and he missed his mother.
Okay, good. Well tried. Afterwards, Pranshi. Now Pranshi is lost. Pranshi, if you don't reply today, now I'm going to mark you absent. And it is very much compulsory for your parents to talk to me today. Because you are doing nothing in my English class. I want to talk to your parents of Pranshi. To this PTM. You know there is a PTM today? I have sent you one message yesterday on WhatsApp. It is very much compulsory to attend PTM. Now Pranshi is nowhere. Aryan Chopra, you tell me this answer. Aryan Chopra. Aryan Chopra, you tell me this answer. Yes, I know you are not able to unmute yourself. Because you don't know the answer. Aryan, are you listening to me? Type in chat box. Type your answer in chat box. Hurry up. If you are not able to unmute yourself, type your answer in chat box. Okay, Simran, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. The poet says that he loves the sound of the pitter-patter of the rain on his roof. He says that it refreshes its mind. He enjoys the nature in his cozy bed. He collects many memories of the past, which come back into his mind as dreams. So he says that as he listens to the patter of the rain upon the roof, he has many new dreams in his mind, and the memories of the past come back in the form of dreams. The poet tells that how his mother is no longer alive, but still in the past, she used to love him a lot. She used to consider him a darling and would let him sleep till the daybreak and have sweet dreams. The poet says that due to the sound of the rain, it makes an echo in his heart, which makes him feel so relieved and contented. The poet can still feel his mother, that she is looking at him as he listens to the song made by the raindrops. He correlates the sound of the rain with his past, with his present. That is why the poet is moved by the sound of the rain. Whenever he hears this sound, it brings back all the memories, and he is always reminded of his mother, that how she used to tuck him and his siblings in the bed and used to look at them with pure love in her eyes.
Very good, very nice. You have spoken so well. Okay. So, bachche, now you have to do these question answers and the three questions, extra questions I have discussed with you. You are supposed to do all these questions in your peer notebook. Okay. I'm going to share one more question with you. You write down. What does melancholy darkness mean, and what does it do? What does melancholy darkness mean, and what does it do? What does melancholy darkness mean, and what does it do? What is the meaning of melancholy? Melancholy means sad. What does melancholy darkness mean, and what does it do? Melancholy means sad. And what does it do? See, here darkness is described, and darkness is personified as gloomy depressed. Depressed and sad. Darkness is personified as gloomy, depressed, and sad. It is even crying. It is even crying. Okay. How it is crying? Because its rain is going on. It's raining and it is described as shedding tears. Shedding tears. So, bachche, this is the last answer. So, who is going to tell me this answer? Who is going to tell me this answer? Hurry up. Same 4, 5. Others are not bothered in class. Same 4, 5 students are raising their hands. What about others, those who are doing nothing in class? So many prompts are given, hints are given right in front of you. All these hints are written and you are not able to tell me the answer. That is really surprising. Ridhika, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. Melancholy means sadness. So melancholy, darkness means sad darkness. The rain on the roof take the poet to the sad memories of his mother. That's what poet means by melancholy darkness. Melancholy darkness refers to the dark rain-bearing clouds. The poet imagines that the cloud covering the sky are gloomy and depressed because they are heavy and gray. The poet further imagines that the clouds are weeping and their tears are falling down as raindrops.
Okay, good. Good. Your efforts are good. Okay, now Arzu, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. Melancholy darkness means, which is associated with sadness by poets. It is due to the rain clouds and it causes rain to fall just like melancholy causes weeping or crying. It becomes quite gloomy when it rains as there is no sunshine.
Okay, good. Now time is running out. We have to over the class. But say you have Sunday tomorrow. And on that day, you can do your work. You can complete your notebooks. You can do these question answers in your peer notebook. I will be sending you the schedule. According to the given schedule, you have to send me the notebooks for checking. And in your group, I have sent one message that there is a Sahodaya poster making competition and only one student has shown willingness. And today is the last day. So who wants to participate? Please give your names after the class to me. Bachche, Nitish is asking about offline classes. This information given to you whenever it will be organized. Okay. Okay, Dhiren wants to ask something. Yes, Dhiren, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, I want to ask you what is the meeting ID and password for the PTM?
Same, I'm your class in charge, my meeting ID and password.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, students, thank you and have a nice day.